Back to our channel Industry Edge Skills. Today we'll learn about what is analog signal, how analog signal can be converted into digital signal, and we can get the output. So we'll start with the basic instruction. In this basic instruction, when you drop down this, you will find a folder called conversion operation. Just drop down this menu, you can find two blocks, which is scalex and nomex. Okay, so we'll take these two block into our network. Fine. Now these are the blocks which will take the input signal from the analog, and they will convert that. As you all know that analog is a integer value, means analog signal gives some integer value, will convert those integer value into real, and again we will take those real values and we will scale them as per our required values, and we will get the output, and that value we will take to the comparator, and we will see that is that value is working with our comparing value or not. Okay, let's start with NOMX. Before going to the NOMX, just remember here we have to assign that. So I will take here int to real, then here again we are converting the real into, so for seeing the analog signal we have two range, means from 0, means the low range, to the high range. So our low range is 0, our high range is 27648. You can take the input from the analog, means how you can take the analog signal as an input. So we have certain addresses. How you can know that which address, from which address we are going to get the analog input? So just go to PLC, you can go from here also, device and network, as I have opened this previously, so you can click on this and you can find PLC CPU 1512 here. In that, just go to device view. In the device view, you can find AI2 AQ2. That means two analog inputs and two analog outputs. And the addresses of those analog inputs and outputs are from 64 to 67. Fine. We will just minimize this and we'll come here. So as we know the input is from 64, so we'll take one word. W64. Okay, this is my analog input. Then output, as we have taken one word, so my output also I will take in memory, but it will be also in word. Okay, the same output we are going to take here in scalex also, but here I want to scale my value between 0 to 10. As I have a voltage regulator of 0 to 10, so I will take 0 to 10 so that I can scale those values into digital. Means now I am going to take my 0 to 10 volt and I will convert them into digital outputs. Let's give the minimum as 0 and the maximum as 10, and my values I will be taking this output as my input. Fine. And my output value is QWC. As this is integer and we have taken the input in word, so my output will be in word. So I am taking QW80. We will just save this and we'll compile this. as you can see there is zero error and zero warning. Now I'm going to download this program into my PLC. Fine, program is being already downloaded, zero error and zero warning. So I'm going to make it online. Now my network is online. Now to understand the upcoming parts, you need to see to our hardware. So this is my hardware. Hardware having one voltage source and a regulator from 0 to 10 volt. Okay, and it is being connected with two quad wires to my analog input. These are my analog inputs. From voltage source I have connected here. Now you can see whenever I will vary my voltage, you can see there is change in values. You can see the input values are changing with respect to that. My output is also changing in NOMEX, and we are taking those output as input in scalex, and we are converting that into gain, which is in 10. Our next step is to scale that. Means now we have scaled that in the range of 0 to 10. Now we need to assign certain outputs of digital. Digital output I will assign like Q0. Getting the output or not. Fine, we'll go to offline mode. Some comparators. Here you can go in this comparator operation, and I will better like, okay, let's take greater than equal to. I'll take one comparator greater than equal to as my output is in. So double click on this. I will take int. Here my outputs are in word, so it shouldn't exit. In safer point I have taken double int. So here I will just add this output, copy, and I can paste it here. Fine, I give my output over here, and now I will set certain limit. The limit is suppose 0 to 10, so I can keep here वैल्यू एग्जिट इट गोज अबव 5, मतलब जैसे कि मेरा वैल्यू 5 के ऊपर आता है देन आई विल गेट सर्टन आउटपुट. डबल क्लिक ऑन दिस विल गेट आउटपुट एंड माई आउटपुट विल बी Q0.0 विच इज बुलियन आउटपुट. ओके, सो एज प्रीवियसली आई हैव यूज दिस आउटपुट फॉर शोइंग यू द एंड गेट, सो दिस नेम इज ऑलरेडी देयर. सेव दिस एंड अगेन विल लोड दिस टू PLC. Will go online. PLS is ready, so I will vary my values. So as my values are increasing, slowly moving this, you can see we have a gap of 0.5 voltage for scaling. So as soon as I get 0.5 here, it will start from 0. So as I will reach to 4.5, this is the scaling value for the 5 which I have connected as a comparator. So let's go to 4.5. So now it is 4.2, 4.3 and 4. You can see as soon as I reached here 4.5, my output is on. As we have scaled that, when we get 0 to 10, between this the value reaches, we will get certain output in QW. 80, and that we have kept in our comparator function, and we have given a value. If the value is greater than or equals to 5, then I will get the output. As my 4.5 is equals to the scaling part, we have got an output in Q0.0, and the address is in Boolean, which is our digital output. Like, suppose I will take, this four different set points in different outputs. As now I have kept 5, let's keep four different as for 5 I have kept 0.0. let's make it to start some outputs also. Q0.0, I will take here Q0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Okay, so my outputs are ready. Now I need to give some set points. So we will start with 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. As soon as these barrier points will be crossed by our voltage, we will get digital outputs in form of our LEDs. I hope all my LEDs are visible. Let's save this and download this to the PLC. I'll just go back. My networks are on and my voltage is in 0.0. As soon as I will move my knob, you can see there is change in values. Fine. So I have kept some barrier points like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So as soon as the voltage cross these barrier values, we'll get our digital outputs. Let's see. Okay, our first output is on. Second, third. So as my value is 4.5, means it is crossing the limit of threshold 5. You can see this. See, if I'm going back, this is the threshold point. As soon as this value cross 4.5, which is the scaling point for the 5, see, it is off now. Now I will go to 5.5, my last rung will be on. It is 5.1, 5.4 and 5.5. See, my last output is also on. So as soon as I will decrease the voltage, all my output will be off. So is it interesting? I can show you one another interesting also thing over here. If we convert this voltage into current, we can scale the current also here. Just see. So we just need to vary our knob very carefully. Slowly I am moving the knob and I am getting the output. Getting the output here now in forms of current. So this is how we have scaled the analog input into digital output. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you find this video interesting and informative, please do like and subscribe. Our next video will be on SCADA software. We will be showing you the SCADA screen, how they are designed, and I will show you an example and the process how the thing works in SCADA system in the upcoming videos. Please do subscribe so that you will get the notification of that video. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.